Hello folks, Everchanger here for episode 33 of Pokemon Liquid Crystal. Last time we finished things up in the Rocket Hideout, and we decided we would come over here to the gym and take care of business here. So, in this episode, we are going to be taking on the gym leader, Price. Now, I said in the last episode that I knew exactly how to do this ice skating pattern, but honestly, it's been quite a while, so I'm hoping I don't embarrass myself too terribly badly when I'm doing this. I know it's like some weird spiral trick you gotta do, but I've never been totally clear on how to do it. This is probably gonna wind up being way more embarrassing than it needs to be. Let's see here. Is it up? No. I remember knowing exactly how to do this, and now I'm just screwing it up, and I feel so bad about it because I played this game so much, and I've always said that I've played this game so much, and now I'm just totally screwing this up. Let's see, is it this way? Gosh, half the episode is just going to be me screwing around on these ice panels and not actually fighting the gym leader. Is it this way? I know it was like some sort of weird spiral-ish pattern. I'm not just totally clear on how it works. Oh, let this be a sign of things to come for the ice path, because there's a dungeon after this a little ways called the ice path that is pretty much all ice puzzles, and it's gonna be bad if this is any indication. Come on, which way is it? I'm gonna run out of things to talk about before I run into the gym leader. Come on. How do we even do this? Is it this way? Yes, there we go. I knew it was some sort of weird spiral. So I was gonna open up with Growlithe, but I think the odds are against me that he's gonna open up with something that's also part water type. So I'm gonna try switching in Lantern and see what good that does me. And without further ado, let's get things started. Pokemon have many experiences in their lives, just like we do. I too have seen and suffered much in my life. Since I am your elder, let me show you what I mean. I have been with Pokemon since before you were born. I do not lose easily. I, Price, the Winter Trainer, shall demonstrate my power. And here we go. This is our seventh gym battle against the gym leader, Price. Now, interesting fact. Oh, good call. There we go. It's part water type. Interesting fact, in the manga called Pokemon Adventures, or Pokemon Special by the purists in the community, Price is actually a villain, which is pretty fascinating. That's one thing I really, really like about this manga over the anime, is that it takes a lot of really cool creative liberties with the actual storylines. In the anime, they like to follow the storylines pretty much to the letter, but in Pokemon Adventures, they really like to play around with the formula, and I think that makes it, in part, a lot more enjoyable than the anime itself. And I believe that they only have to announce one more volume for US release to make us all caught up with the Japanese release of the manga, which is really, really awesome. I always really liked the manga ever since I started buying it in 2009 with their reprinting that they decided to do. And I don't know, I guess I've just been on a kick of it these days. Withdrawing Seal, that is interesting. We got a Pilosine coming out, which will nullify Spark, because that is part ground type. But we do have Water Gun, which isn't the best at- oh gosh. Well, there goes that. Water Gun wasn't the best water type attack, but I don't think it would have mattered anyway, because we're knocked out. Which is all sorts of lovely. Let's bring out Feraligatr here and see what a Surf will do. This Piloswine is level 42, which is pretty crazy. But we have to be thankful that it's not a Mamoswine, because Mamoswine is not in this version of the game. It was introduced in Diamond and Pearl. So, I think we dodged a bullet there, and Piloswine actually goes down, which is super awesome. Feraligatr gets level 41, which is very, very good. Growlithe gets almost 2,000 experience and gets level 31. Trying to learn Flame Wheel, which is a decent attack. Let's see here. I think we're going to get rid of Ember, because even though we're swapping out a special move for a physical move, Ember does have, like, about 40 power compared to 60 power. I'm trying to do math in my head and it's just not working. And I think 60 power, regardless of it being physical or special, is probably just overall better in the long run. especially since you don't really have to worry about physical and special attacks as much in the single player campaign. So I think we're just gonna do that. Let's switch over to Alakazam, give it some love. And I think we're doing decently well in this fight, which I think frees me up to talk about some other things. One thing that's of note is that yesterday I started writing down notes for the next Let's Play. I've decided I really would like to do another one, and this is actually one I wanted to do before Liquid Crystal, but I actually decided to do Liquid Crystal first, mostly on a whim, and we got a Glalie coming out. That is very interesting. He did not have a Glalie in the original game, obviously, because Glalie is a Generation 3 Pokemon, so that's a bit of a curveball there. But yes, I am planning out a new Let's Play on the channel. It will not start until after Liquid Crystal is done, both Johto and Kanto, so don't worry about it too much. I'm not going to really be rushing through this or anything, trying to get to the next one, because the next one, I actually am tentatively planning. This is all tentative, by the way. I am tentatively planning for it to be a 100% run. And to go along with that, it will actually be an official first-party Nintendo title. It will not be a hack of any kind, it will be a first-party title, and I am also tentatively planning on playing it on Nintendo hardware instead of what I'm doing here, playing it on an emulator. So I'll leave you guys up to guess as to what it is. I'm really, really excited about it. It's one of my favorite games of all time. And no, it is not Xenoblade Chronicles, because I'm not an insane person. So scratch that off, but basically anything else you can think of, it's a bit of a fair game, and hopefully that project will come to fruition sooner rather than later. I'm super duper excited about it. It's gonna have on-screen graphics, detailing, collectibles, and all sorts of cool stuff like that, so get excited. And this Glalie is actually doing a decent amount of damage to my team, so hopefully this slash will be able to bring it down to size. I think one more slash ought to be able to do it, which is good. A little bit of a voice crack there. I'm sure I've voice cracked like 36 times over the course of this series, but oh well, I guess it's just one of those job hazards, occupational hazards. And does a decent amount of damage. I'm really hoping we can get a critical here, but it looks like Blizzard's doing next to nothing to our Feraligatr here, which is very, very good, because Blizzard is usually a devastating attack and you really don't want to get hit by it, but Feraligatr's walling it like a champ, so I don't think we have to worry about it too terribly much. Alright. Slash, can we bring it down? Ooh, so very close. But he's not potioning, which means, assuming we can tank this Blizzard, which I think there's pretty much 100% chance that we will, we should be able to bring down this Glalie no problem, which is super awesome. And Glalie has fainted. Get lots of experience for that. Almost 2,000 on Growlithe again, but now we've got a Dewgong coming out, which could be a bit of an issue. I'm going to stick with Feraligatr basically because it walls both of Dewgong's stab types. Stab meaning same type attack bonus. So I think we should have a relatively easy time, especially given Dewgong is actually only level 38 compared to Feraligatr's 41 and the 42 of the other Pokemon on his team. So looks like we should have this in the bag. Oh no. 10% chance of freezing. Really? Oh, wow. Defrosted. Okay. That's the one weird thing about the freeze status. It happens so few times, and when it does actually happen, you wind up defrosting like the very same turn, basically. So part of me wonders why it's even in the game, because it's not really that functional in what it does. And I actually got a not-so-pointless critical there, because it looks like we might be able to win this fight this turn. And it looks like we have. Feraligatr gets a bunch of experience, Growlithe gets over 1500 once again, level 32, which is super great. I think we should expect evolving Growlithe to happen in the very near future. And Price was defeated! Ah, I am impressed by your prowess. With your strong will, I know you will overcome all life's obstacles. You are worthy of this badge. Get loads of money for winning, and David received the Glacier Badge for the 7th time in all of its one-word glory. That badge will raise the special stats of Pokemon. It also lets your Pokemon use Whirlpool to get across real Whirlpools. And this is a gift from me. And we get TM16. Is that Icy Wind? I believe it is. Yes, it is. That TM contains Icy Wind. It inflicts damage and lowers speed. It demonstrates the harshness of winter. Hmm. You seem like a responsible trainer. I'd like to give you this Pokemon. Oh, okay. He's giving us a Pokemon for having such a great Pokemon battle. Oh, it looks like you have no room for this Pokemon. Come back when you have room for it. That is definitely new. He did not give out a Pokemon in the original game. That's for dang sure. One thing I'm curious about is that since Whirlpool was demoted to a TM in this game, I'm wondering if you actually need the badge to use it, because it's not an HM. So it might have required some programming tricks, but anyway. We have a call from Professor Elm. David, how are things going? I called because something weird is happening with the radio broadcasts. They were talking about Team Rocket. David, do you know anything about it? Maybe Team Rocket has returned. No, that just can't be true. Sorry to bug you. Take care. Very, very, very interesting. Unfortunately, the radio doesn't actually work in this version of the beta for Pokemon Liquid Crystal, so we can't actually verify these claims. So I'm just going to go out there and say that there is a radio broadcast that is going around the Johto region talking about Team Rocket's return. Because we can't check it for ourselves, so I might as well not withhold it from you guys. But anyway, I think we should probably deposit one of our Pokemon to see what Price has to give us. So, I'm just going to check that out real fast. I don't plan on using it, obviously. Let's just drop Alakazam in box one right here real quick, and then we'll go check out what Price has to give us. Which means, unfortunately, I have to brave the ice puzzle a second time in this episode, and even though I just did it like 10 minutes ago, I'm probably going to screw it up again, so I sincerely apologize. Let's see here. I think I know what I'm doing. There we go. That wasn't too bad. And we're right back. So let's see what he has to give us. It is a Cast Form. Very, very interesting. Cast Form is a third generation Pokemon, introduced in the Hoenn region, obviously. That Pokemon was given to me by a scientist from Hoenn. I think you're worthy of it. It has an interesting ability. I don't remember exactly what it's called, but basically what it does is it has an ability that will cause it to change form based on the weather in battle. It can have a rain form, a sun form, and a hail form. For some very strange reason, there is no sandstorm form, which is unfortunate. I remember before Platinum came out, they had the silhouettes of what eventually wound up being the Rotom forms. And I was hoping that Fan Rotom was actually a sandstorm form for Cast Form. This is what it looks like. But unfortunately, that was not the case, and we just got 5 Rotom forms. So it's a very, very odd omission. But Cast Form actually also has an interesting attack called Weather Ball that will also change type with the weather, and I believe that attack will actually become ground type in a sandstorm. So I think we should reshuffle our Pokemon team a little bit. I think I'll actually transfer the experience share over to Lantern because it's lagging a little bit behind in the levels. So let's just get all the way down here to the bottom of the Slow Slug Generation 3 bag and give it the experience share. And I think we'll switch it out for Growlithe in the front. And that should be good. So, without further ado, we have some interesting developments with Team Rocket on the radio. And where on earth in Hoenn could we possibly... Not Hoenn. Where on earth in Johto could we possibly find a place that broadcasts radio signals? Well, I can think of no other place than the Goldenrod City Radio Tower, so let's go investigate real quick. Zoom! And here we are in Goldenrod City. Interesting, ominous rainstorm going down here. And this is the wrong way. So let's nip right down here. So this is the radio tower. Take over the radio tower. What? It's none of your business. Suspicious. Let's head right on in to see what the commotion is all about. And we've got Team Rocket's theme music blaring. Oh gosh, what could possibly be going on? I have no idea. Hello, I'm sorry, but we're not offering any tours today. I would think not. We have Team Rocket invading the radio tower right here. So, I think without further ado, we should head right on up and fight a couple of grunts to see if we can get some information. We've finally taken over the radio tower. Now everyone will get to experience the true terror of Team Rocket. We'll show you how scary we are. I'm sorry if I sound like way, way more hyper than I have in previous episodes, but this is probably my favorite part of Pokemon Crystal. Like, I just love how Team Rocket just pretty much takes over the whole of Goldenrod City. We'll find out later that they actually not only have taken over the radio tower, but they've also taken over the underground path and the basement of the Goldenrod City department store. So it's pretty crazy what their reach is, and Growlithe is already almost dead, which is unfortunate, so I think we're going to have to switch out to someone better. I think we should probably start using Pidgeotto a lot, because it is very, very, very close to evolving, and I think we want to get a Pidgeot really, really soon, because it is... Are you kidding me? Onix, are you kidding me with that Onix right now? Oh my god, that's like the worst. That AI really, really, really outplayed me well. I'm quite impressed. Half of me is wondering if it's actually cheating. But I think Surf will probably bring this Onix right down to size. So let's take it right on down here, and it is dead. Fainted. Gotta say fainted. No dying in Pokemon unless you're watching one of the movies. In which case, they'll play with your soul. Pidgeotto is trying to learn Feather Dance. There is not a bat's chance in all heck that I'm going to be teaching it Feather Dance because I find it entirely useless. And I believe that Raticate's going to be coming right back out. I think in the interest of time, I'll just keep Feraligatr in. Because Pidgeotto will still get experience from fighting this Raticate, I think. Because it was out in combat against it earlier. I actually don't know for sure now that I'm thinking about it, so we'll have to see. Feraligatr gets 1,000. Lantern gets a bunch. No, I guess Pidgeotto got cheated out of that one, so that's kind of lame. Too strong. We must watch you. Yeah, all they're going to do is stare at us as we make our way up this tower. It's not like they're actually going to actively try and stop us. Like, I don't get why they didn't just pile all on top of me here instead of just letting me walk right on by once I defeat all their Pokemon. I'm sure some of these guys have to be at least a little bit muscular. Lullabies on the radio may make Pokemon sleep. Really? No screaming for help because of this horrible, horrible invasion that is taking place? Jiggly. Aw, Jigglypuff is sad. Okay, so I think we've actually got quite a bit done in this episode. I think we're probably approaching like 15, maybe 20-ish minutes on the clock right now. If I'm wrong, I apologize, but I think I've already sort of half teased the end of this episode like twice now. So I think we're going to actually end it off here. So next time on Pokemon Liquid Crystal, we're going to be delving further into the radio tower to find out the extent of Team Rocket's evil takeover. See you guys next time!